But this pretty much remains the same for mobile application or any other thing. Just these runners or this tool would change for mobile apps, right? For React Native, for Android, for anything else. Hey everyone, welcome back. And in this video, I'm gonna be discussing about how you can test your code as a developer so that you're not shipping bad code on production. What are some of the best practices and what kind of test you should be aware about? Let's go. If you're new here, make sure you leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon. This is free of cost and helps the channel grow. This video is a part of Codedamn's t-shirt giveaway program for the month. If you want to take part and win an amazing Codedamn t-shirt, all you have to do is leave a comment on this video about what you think, and that's it, you are eligible. If your comment gets a heart from Codedamn, you will win a t-shirt for absolutely free. Let's start this pyramid of testing from the very bottom layer. That is the first thing you can do as a developer, and that is called as static testing. Now, static testing is something which your compiler is automatically doing if you are using languages like Rust, C, C++, things like these, which are statically typed languages, right? So these are statically typed languages, and we have discussed the difference between static and dynamic in another video. But with dynamic language, for example, JavaScript, you don't get those opportunities. For example, with Python as well, you don't get those opportunities. So static testing is missing in these languages. At least in JavaScript, you can implement this by using TypeScript instead, which is very useful and very helpful, because once you include static testing with JavaScript, you get the benefits of dynamically typed language, but the security of statically typed language as well, till a certain extent. But yeah, I mean, static testing should be your first priority. If you have a small JavaScript code base, it's a good idea to migrate it into TypeScript. If you want to write in Rust, C, C++, that's a good choice as well. After static testing comes unit testing, which is basically taking the fundamental unit of your code, whatever that unit is, that's usually a function, and then testing against it. For example, you can have a function which is something like is prime, right? And you could write a few unit tests against this, where you supply the input, you know the output, whether that's true or false, and you basically just check that function is working fine or not. Let's say for 10,000 numbers, right? Or whatever you want to check against. But unit testing basically means that you just pick up a fundamental unit of your program. This could very well be, let's say, a huge site like Wolfram Alpha, right? And probably the programmers there might have written a unit test for this, or maybe you have a graphing library, for example, a graphing website like Desmos. So there, if you have written functions like these or some other functions as well, then, you know, making unit tests for those is not so bad idea, because if these functions collapse, pretty much your whole logic or your whole website will collapse, right? So you want unit tests against these functions. The next form of testing is in the pyramid is integration tests. Basically, you can think about this. They're kind of like unit tests, but now you are combining a lot of functionality and trying to test it together, right? For example, you can have a function which calculates a square root of a number, right? And then you have another function which actually calculates the roots of quadratic equation, right? Ax squared plus bx plus c. So this could be a unit test, but the testing of that quadratic function or anything which involves multiple such components can be called as an integration test, right? Again, this is happening on the code level, the static testing. This is also happening on the code level, and this is also happening on the code level. By code level, what I mean is that you're writing some sort of code which evaluates this code, and everything is happening in the CLI, or, you know, in your editor itself, right? The reason I mention this is because the other testing, the last form of testing which we will discuss, is a bit interesting. The final form of testing which is available is called as end-to-end testing. And this end-to-end testing, also known as E2E, and this pretty much closes our pyramid of testing, which obviously looks like a stack instead of a pyramid. But this end-to-end testing, what it means is that you consider your whole application as a black box, right? So this is your app, and you just try to simulate a user's behavior and try to see if the behavior is, I mean, for a given behavior, if the output is correct or not, right? And you don't test the code as per se, but you actually test the features and functionalities, right? So this behavior right here should be, you can think of something which a real user would do, and you expect how it should go along, right? For example, logging in your application, creating a graph, for example, and seeing if the graph matches, creating a new account, for example, even doing some sort of payment or something, which is a mock, you can mock most of the paths here. But thinking about this, you can see these are some high level actions, right? High value actions from your user. So end-to-end testing allow you to do that, where you actually simulate a whole user, so you don't have to manually just go ahead and open the browser, click somewhere, then wait for the results and do all that stuff. And of course, I mean, you can see the amount of time a test would take to run would increase when you go from bottom to top, right? Static testing is very fast because as you are writing your code or as you are compiling, it gets evaluated. Unit testing would be a little bit slower because it needs a runner now. For example, jest is a runner, unit and integration testing both. Jest and let's say mocha is a runner. For other languages, there might be more runners. These are two for Node. Then integration test, again, you need a runner, but again, integration tests become a little bit complicated because you are testing a bunch of functions together instead of a single function. And finally, end-to-end testing are the slowest because here you use tools like Cypress to simulate a full user, right? Which interacts with your black box app. And then you test against, you know, if the behavior was right or wrong. Plus Cypress, an end-to-end test could be the most flaky as well, because for the most part, I mean, you can mock away a lot of network and, you know, API stuff, but you still, in some cases, it's not possible to do so. So you still would have some sort of reliance on how the network behaves, how the responses come, and from the third party, from some other site, so on and so forth. So yeah, I mean, but this is a very strong testing mechanism, which ensures that if you're shipping your application, it's not broken for at least those critical features, right? For whatever test you have written. So I think the formula is that you just write end-to-end testing for the most critical parts and use integration and unit testing for everything else, right? Because these would be much faster compared to this end-to-end testing thing. And of course, my recommendation is to use Cypress as a end-to-end testing tool, especially if you are using browsers, right? This is in context to web development if you are using Cypress, but this pretty much remains the same for mobile application or any other thing. Just these runners or this tool would change for mobile apps, right? For React Native, for Android, for anything else. All right, so that was a small video on what sort of tests exist as a developer you should worry about. I hope this was helpful. If yes, do like the video and subscribe to the channel. Let me know in the comments below what you think about testing as a developer, because I do believe testing is one of the horrifying experiences we have to go through as a developer. But trust me, it is worth the pain. You're gonna be saving so much minutes debugging issues on production if you have the correct test written, because they won't happen in the first place. So that is all for this video. Make sure you leave a like, subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I'm gonna see you in the next one really soon.